Okay, in part B, we have a hauntingly similar problem. We have 3 sine 2x minus 1 equals 0. We proceed the same as before and isolate the trig function. Here we would add 1 and divide by 3, and I get sine 2x equals 1/3. So I go over and I think, where is the sine equal to 1/3? Since 1/3 isn't one of the common values, I have to use the inverse trig functions. So sine is positive in quadrant 1 and in quadrant 2. So the arc sine of 1/3, by definition, is a quadrant 1 angle whose sine is 1/3. So that's this guy. And since he's an acute angle, he also serves as the reference angle for him. And so the quadrant 2 would be pi minus that reference angle. And once again, to capture all the solutions, I got to add multiples of 2 pi k for integers k. That captures all the coterminal angles. So back over here, I've got the sine of 2x equals 1/3. So that means that 2x, oops, I want to go back to blue here. So 2x is the arc sine of 1/3 plus any integer multiple of 2 pi, or 2x is pi minus the arc sine of 1/3 plus any integer multiple of 2 pi. All right, so that's that. And now, as before, I'm going to divide both sides by 2, multiply both sides by 1/2. And once again, when you multiply by 1/2, remember to make sure you multiply both terms over here by 1/2. So I get 1/2 arc sine 1/3 plus 1/2 of this gives you pi k, or 1/2 here gives you pi over 2 minus 1/2 arc sine of 1/3. Plus 1/2 here gives you pi k, where k is 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, and so on. So we've solved the equation. Now we want to figure out which of these guys is going to lie between 0 and 2 pi. Now, as we mentioned before, there are 2 solutions to this equation between 0 and 2 pi. And since the angular frequency here is 2, we expect double that, or 4 solutions, just like we did in the previous example. So to help us out, let's remember that the arc sine of 1/3 is an acute angle. It's between 0 and pi over 2, and that's by definition. So what I'm looking at here is 1/2 of that. So if I multiply through by 1/2, 1/2 times 0 is 0. This guy lives between 0 and pi over 4, so that's going to help us out here. When I plug in, of course, k equals 0, I get 1/2 arc sine of 1/3, which is between 0 and pi over 4, so it's between 0 and 2 pi. All right, what if I let k equal 1 and I add pi to that? All right, if I add pi to that, then I've got pi plus something between 0 and pi over 4. That's going to give me something between pi and 5 pi over 4, and so that's also going to be between 0 and 2 pi. If you don't like thinking algebraically, folks, you can always think geometrically. All right, here's 0, here's pi over 4. This angle is between 0 and pi over 4, so if I add pi to it, then I'm going to have to end up between pi and 5 pi over 4. So if I add pi to this, I'm going to be at most over here. Now, if I look at negative 1, then I'm in trouble because this is between 0 and pi over 4. If I'm subtracting pi, it's going to give me a negative. I could see that here as well. If I start here and subtract pi, then I'm going to have a negative angle, so I throw that out. And if I let k equal 2, then I'm adding something to 2 pi, so I'm well beyond 2 pi. So these are the only two members of this family we get that lie between 0 and 2 pi. And now I proceed to the next ones. If I let k equal 0, I've got pi over 2 minus 1 half arcsine 1 third. So I can go think geometrically again where that angle is. So once again, here's the pi over 4. If I take pi over 2 minus this angle, then that means I've got to be somewhere in here. Okay, pi over 2 minus that angle. The smallest I could be pi over 4. The biggest I could be would be pi over 2. So I've got to be in here somewhere. So certainly that's between 0 and 2 pi. And if I add pi to that, I would get 3 pi over 2 minus this guy. Okay, so if I take something in here and add pi to it, that would give me something down in here, which is also between 0 and 2 pi. If I choose k equals negative 1, I would have pi over 2 minus this minus pi. That'd be a minus pi over 2 minus that. So that'd be a negative angle, so we throw that out. And then if I let k equal 2, then I'm going to be having 5 pi over 2 minus this angle, which would land me right here, because 5 pi over 2 would be going all the way around up to here, and then I'd be backing down that angle, and so that would be above 2 pi as well. All right, so once again, we get our four answers. That'll do it for part B. Okay, in part C, the first thing we notice is we have two different trig functions, so that's a little bit new. But more importantly, the arguments of the trig functions are different. Here we've got a 2x, here we've got an x. So the first thing I want to do is get everything at least with the same argument. So I'm going to use an identity. And the identity we're going to use here is the double angle identity. Sine of 2 theta is 2 sine theta cosine theta. So the left-hand side becomes 2 sine x equals cosine x. And I want you to resist the urge at this point to divide both sides by the cosine of x. In general, we normally try to avoid dividing by anything that's a variable in case we lose solutions. So instead of dividing by the cosine, let's subtract it off. Get everything on one side, zero on the other. And now since we have a cosine in common, let's factor that out. So I get cosine of 2 sine x minus 1. Now I can split this. I've got two real numbers that multiply together to give me 0. That means that either the cosine x is 0 or 2 sine x minus 1 is 0. And we actually saw this earlier. We isolate the trig function. We get sine x equal to 1/2. And now I look at these solutions. Okay, so cosine x equals 0. Where does that happen? That happens at x equals pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, etc., and so on. So that's pi over 2 plus pi k. And where's sine x equal to 1/2? Well, that's at pi over 6 plus 2 pi k. Or it's at x equals 5 pi over 6 plus 2 pi k. Or once again, k runs through the integers. All right, so this is our entire solution to this equation. Now what we do is look at what lies between 0 and 2 pi. So in 0 to 2 pi from the first family, I certainly get the pi over 2 when k equals 0. When k equals 1, I get 3 pi over 2. When k equals 2, 3, 4, 5, I'm getting something bigger than 2 pi. When I let k be a negative, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, I get something less than 0. So those are the only two answers I get there. And then I get pi over 6, and that's the only one I get from this family. And then 5 pi over 6, the only one I get from that family. So that'll do it then.